Today, I'm going to show you how the Deek-Robot Motor Shield holds up to all the tests that I do for DCC++. I'm Tom Kovichak, and this is Tom's Trains and Things. This channel was created to help other modelers who are in need of guidance in pursuing their dream of building a model railroad. And today, we're going to do the Deek-Robot Motor Shield. Now, I've had a hard time finding this one, but it was right there in front of me on eBay, which I haven't used since about 2002 or 2003. So let me show you a close-up of it. It is identical to the Arduino motor shield. In fact, I have this one mounted on a Mega 2560. And I'll bring it right over to here. And here is the Arduino motor shield, which is mounted on an Uno, which is the same size. Now you can see everything on there is identical, even down to the tinker pins. So that's what we're going to talk about today. So let's get started with that right now. It's only been 20 days, but I finally got my Deek-Robot motor shields. Now, if you could remember, my DF robot came in the big DHL bag and then the box and then a smaller box. But here are two motor shields in this bag right here. And I could see in the back where some of the pins have been poking through. So let me open this thing up right here. The anti-static bags. All right. So, two motor shields, Deek-Robot. Let me open one of them up. There it is, 298. I think the two of these cost me $11 and some change and like $2 for shipping. So it was $13 for two of them from eBay. We'll test this thing out and show you how it works. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to disable the VIN connection on the bottom. I'm going to scrape out the jumper that's on there. And hopefully I won't go down too thick on it. And it looks like I scraped through it, but to be on the positive side, I'll put a meter to it. See, I got the audio on here. So even though it looks like there is no connection, the only way to tell is if you put a meter on it right now. It's okay. Just to make sure. Okay, there we go. I have my steam locomotive number 106 on the running track, and I have the Deek-Robot hooked up to the Mega. As you can see right here, I got all four lights on. 106 is on the running track. Now we're going to pull up the let's see, we'll pull this up over here so we can see this. I have this started right over here. And I'll show you in the preferences, we have everything set for DCC++. So we're good to go on that. So what we'll do is we'll pull up the throttle. Well, I'll give an easier way of doing it. We'll pull up the roster, bring this up. We got 106 selected. That'll automatically put the throttle on. We have 106 over here. And what we're going to do is put the bell on. All right, we'll put the headlight on. I don't know if you'll be able to see it. Move on forward first and then the headlight. Okay, you can see the headlight is on. All right, bell, whistle. Okay, take note of the bell duration, because we're going to change that, and we're going to change the whistle on here. Okay. So we'll shut that off. We'll program on the program track. And we'll bring that, this dialog box up here, and let me put it on the program track. So what I'm going to do is shut the power off for a second. And it automatically comes up. So what we'll do over here, okay, we see we got that set at 106. We'll come over to sound, and bell rate is set at 12. So we're going to bring this down to about 4. And that's going to change the bell rate. And what else was we going to change? Okay, Baldwin, okay, classic. So let's go to the Denver Rio Grande single chime for that. And what we'll do is write changes on sheet there. And where else were we here? Did we change anything else? Okay, that's all we changed there. So we come down over here, and you'll see that that's those two right there. We'll keep the volume the same. We'll keep everything else the same on here. So we'll close that out, save it. And we'll select this up here, and we'll put it on the main track. Okay, I have it on the main track. I'm going to use a different camera on here. Okay, so you could see it right there. Let me adjust that a little bit. Okay, we'll put the throttle back on for number 106. We'll shut the power off a second and turn it back on. Have it in forward, we'll turn the headlight on, the bell. Now you can see the bell's a little bit faster. And that is definitely a different whistle. I like that one there. Okay, so you see that it worked on there. Let's start this thing up. Put it in reverse. Go a little bit slower in reverse. So we're going to keep those sounds like they are. I'm going to put this back on the programming track. Passing whistle, enable automatic sound control. Okay, we'll turn this on. Automatic whistle, automatic bell, automatic blowdown. Write changes on cheat, come over here. And you can see which CVs it changed. Number 31, or changed 198 to 31. Okay, so we'll save that and we'll put that back on. The main track. I don't want to do it on the program track, because I've heard people do that on the DCC++ and burnt up their motor shield. So I don't know if it'll burn up mine, but I don't want to take that chance. We'll shut it off for a second. Turn it back on. Now what I'm going to do, put it in forward. Move this down so I can see what's here. And we'll go back to that other camera and take a look at it. Okay, put the headlight on. Okay, the bell. I like that whistle there. Okay, so what we're going to do, bump this up. So it's got the automatic whistle when it starts, and same thing when it stops.
Okay, the only thing is it stops instantaneously. I'll go through that test of reading everything on there to see what happens. See if it doesn't on the Deek-Robot like it did on the DF robot. You can see it's on the program track, and I'll bring this over here. Select that one, program track, program. Okay, we'll come over here to CVs and read full sheet, and we'll see if it changes any and if it skips any. Now, so far it's not skipping any. We don't see anything in the red so far, so that's a good indication that it's reading every one of the CVs. And as it's going, I can't scroll down through the list, so you just have to take my word for it that it's working. And I'll put you on this, and as it's reading, you could see the locomotive just inching slightly forward every time it acknowledges the read. And it's up to CV75 right now, and it's continuing to read. And once it goes up to reads around once, it's going to go back and read it a second time. So it's on CV94 right now. It's 138. Okay, now you can see it's starting to go back. Reading CV 39, 40. So it went all the way up to the top and then starting to read it over again. And then once it goes through the CVs a second time, it'll be finished. Okay, now it's saying okay. So it's okay. And we'll go through here and see all of them are red, and none of them say edited or anything like that or not able to read. So we're good to go on here. And so 7 is 64, 8 is 141. Those two give you an indication of the manufacturer, and there was a couple others on there. And let me see if I could bring it up over here. Okay. Manufacturer ID 141, manufacturer version number 64, and then the user ID number 1, firmware version 14 and 25. Before, these were 0. Spectrum Quick Start Guide, okay, with the Bachmann locomotives. This one has a little bit more sounds than the other ones, but when you go down and try to identify what decoder is on there, sometimes you have a list of maybe 30 decoders. So you got to go down there and try to find the decoder that is closest to what you have. As far as I'm concerned, the Deek-Robot works good. It works fine on the program track, and it works fine on the main track. I'm satisfied with it. I'll recommend that. So there's the Arduino, there's the Palulu, and then there's the Deek-Robot with the 298 chip on it. Now, for some reason, on the website for Deek-Robot, and let me pull that up real quick over here. Website, products, and shields. And you'll see right there, showing page 1 of 1. There's no next page, and it just shows the L293D, which is the one with the lower current on there. Arduino, Palulu, and Deek-Robot. That's the three. I haven't done the Palulu. Maybe next month I'll pick one up and try that one out. At least that one is 3 amps per channel. And so, and there's a little bit of different wiring on it. So we'll play around with that and show you how to use that if anybody else wants to use it. Now, for those of you that got the motor shields that did not work for DCC++, I'll do a video and show you how to hook it up so you could run some motors on there for some automation on your model railroad. If you want to put any kind of movement in your model railroad other than the locomotives or something, that you need something moving, say like you have a machine shop where they use steam and they use belts all over the place to run everything. They had a main drive shaft along the ceiling with pulleys going down to each one of the machines. If you want to do something like that, if you want to get elaborate like that, you could do that with a motor shield and a DC motor, a small DC motor. If you got an old printer, take it apart and you can get some small DC motors out of there that are 12 volt. So, until the next time, we'll see you.